Welcome students, this is the last part of my video on what is democracy and why democracy. So today we will be discussing on important topic, why democracy, why do we need democracy. So we will be discussing on arguments against the democracy and argument in favor of democracy. So let's get started, okay. So in this video we will discuss why democracy, why do we need democracy, okay. Debating merits of democracy. So first is argument against democracy, okay, why we don't need democratic form of government. So it's against the democratic form of government. So number one point, so first of all I would like to tell you that before starting the chapter, this part why democracy is the important part of the chapter. So please listen carefully, and the most of the questions also will be coming from this part of the chapter only. Okay, so please be attentive. So argument against democracy. So number one point is leader keeps changing in a democratic form of government. So after every 5 years in the democratic form of government, leader keeps on changing. Okay, so there is some cases that the leader does not change also, but what happens after every 5 years, usually what happens in a democratic country, leader keeps on changing. Okay, this leads to instability means it is not a democratic government, is not a type of a stable type of government. The government keeps on changing, okay, and another person will come, and what happens, he had a different idea, then he will put up a different idea after every 5 years. So that is instable form of government, or a democratic form of government is. Okay, number two is democracy is all about political competition and power play. So democratic form of government is all about political competition and power play. Okay, so number two argument against the democracy is democratic government is all about political competition. It is a type of a competition to win an election and rule a country. Okay, and it all in a democratic form of government, also the people also shows the power, the leader also shows power. Okay, and there is no scope of morality. Morality means principle concerning the distinction between right and wrong. So the leader does not see what is wrong and what is right. He is always in after winning the election. Okay, and in the other word, you can say that the chair of leader is important than any other thing. Okay, in the democratic form of government. Okay, number three, many people have to be consulted in a democracy, which leads to delay. So to take a major decision, what happens actually in the democratic form of government, to take a major decision, the government have to consult with so many other people. Okay, then only he can take a decision. So this also leads to delay to take a decision. Okay, number four is elected leaders do not always know the best interest of the people, which leads to bad decision. So elected leaders, so those who are newly elected leaders, they do not know the best, what the people needs, what the people are interested in. So this also, that's why the government, democratic government, fails in satisfying the needs of people. Okay, in satisfying people, you can say. And and number five is democracy leads to corruption as it based on electoral competition. So democracy also leads to corruption as it based on the electoral competition, as it is based on the election of the people, as it is based on the voting of the people. That so it also leads to corruption. The government is spends lots of money to win election. So that is what the corruption is. Okay. And same thing happens in our country also. Okay. Next is ordinary people do not know what is good for them. They should not decide anything. Okay. So ordinary people, okay, does not know what is good for them. Okay. Next in a democratic form of government. Okay. And the next is democracy leads to frequent change in leadership. Sometimes this can set back big decisions and affect the government efficiency. So, as I've already told, democracy is a form of government in which the leader changes frequently. And what happens because of this? Because if the leader keeps on changing frequently, then the thinking of the different leader, it doesn't match with each other. So because of that, what happened? This can set back a big decision and affect the government efficiency also. Okay. Next is democracy is not a magical solution for all problems. It has not ended poverty in our country and in other parts of the world. So democratic form of government is not a magical solution. So it is a democratic government. Till now has not become very successful because the countries which are following the democratic form of government are not able to end poverty in our country and in other part of the world also. Okay, so it ensures that people can take their decision, but this does not guarantee their decision will be good. So the democratic form of government ensures that the people can take their decision, the people can choose the government. But what happens? But this does not guarantee that their decision will be good. Sometimes the decision of the people will also come wrong or becomes bad. Okay? So people can also make mistakes. So because of that also, the temporary form of government is not a magical solution. So the above mentioned argument, so the democracy may not be the ideal form of government. So all these are whatever the argument I have told you right now is against the form of democracy. So it tells that the above mentioned argument, so that democracy is not the ideal form of government. Okay. So next we move on to the argument in favor of democracy. So what are the arguments in favor of democracy? We'll be discussing. So arguments in favor of democracy. Number one is democracy is better than any other form of government. So democracy is better than any other form of government to the people. It's to fulfill the needs of the people. Democracy requires that the rulers have to attend the needs of the people. As in the democratic form of the government, rulers are elected by the voting of the people by the election. So what happens? The government have to look for the welfare of the people. Okay? So that is why the democratic form of government is good. Okay? Number two is democratic government is more accountable form of government. So democratic government is more accountable form of government. Okay, that means the democratic government ultimate goal is to look for after the welfare of the people. That's why it is more accountable form of government. Okay. Number three is democracy is based on consultation and discussion with the reduce the possibility of taking rash and irresponsible decisions. So in the democratic form of government, what happened? It is based, the government have to consult with other people, okay, with so many other ministers before taking the decision. That's why the possibility of making mistakes in democratic form of government is very rare. Okay, so there is no the government does not make any kind of mistakes in the temporary form of government, because before making the decision, the government have to consult with various other ministers. Okay. Next is number 4. Democracy provides the method to deal with differences and conflicts. Only in the democracy, different groups can live with one another peacefully. So in the democratic form of government, only the different group, that is opposition, you can say, or the ruling party, they also live peacefully in the democratic form of government. Okay. In diverse country like India, where people are from different religion, language, democracy keeps our country together. So in the diverse country like ours, so our country is very diverse. No, because the people from different religion, stays together in our country. So the democratic form of government also, what happens? It unites all the people and keep all those people together. Okay. So this democratic form of government is successful in keeping all the people, the different types of people, together. Okay. So next, number 5 is democracy enhances the dignity of citizens. So democracy gives respect to every and all citizen, whether he is irrespective of rich, poor, caste, creed. The democracy gives all dignity to all the citizens, respect to all the citizens. Okay. In democracy, poorest and the least educated have the same status. So as I told you, poorest also, rich also, high caste people, low caste people, all have the same status in the democratic form of government. Okay. So all the people, there is a principle of political equality in the democratic form of government. All the people are considered equal. Okay. Next, number 6 is democracy allows us to correct our own mistakes. So democracy also allows to correct our own mistakes. If we choose the wrong government this time, then we can choose the better government next time. So democracy also allows us to correct our own mistakes. So there is space for the public discussion on the mistakes, and there is a room for correction. So in democracy, either the ruler have to change the decision, or the ruler can be changed. So in the democratic countries, every 5 years the ruler changes. What happens? Either the ruler have to change the decision, or the people will change the ruler. So the people, all the powers were in the hands of the people. Okay. From the above argument in the favor of democracy, we can conclude that the democracy cannot give us everything, but it is clearly better than any other form of government. From the above argument, we can say that democracy cannot give us everything. Okay? Nothing is perfect. Okay, that's why. But also it is clearly better than any other form of government. So democratic form of government is better than any other form of government. Okay. So these are the arguments against the democracy and in the favor of democracy. So moving on with the chapter, next important topic we have is broader meaning of democracy. I'm not saying border between the two countries, is broader means big. Okay. So broader meaning of democracy. Okay. So the most common form of democracy is representative democracy. So so this type of democracy we have in our country also. The most common form of democracy is what? Representative democracy. So in this, the majority of people rule through their elected representative. So in this, what happens in the representative government, what happens in this, the majority of people rule through the elected representative. Okay, they will be elected by the people. It is so because the modern democracy involves such a large number of people that it is physically impossible for them to sit together and take collective decision. So as the big countries like India, so what happened? We cannot keep all the people, the leader cannot keep all the people together and sitting together with the people, the leader, the government cannot make a decision. That is the reason why from all the different part of the country, the representatives are elected. Okay, and that representative will be the member of parliament and they together will form a government. Okay, and they also takes a collective decision. Okay, as a decision together with the government. Okay, so next is, even if they could, the citizen does not have the time, the desire or the skill to take part in all the decisions. So even if the government is able to sit together with the people also, but what happens, the people don't have the time, okay, and the desire to sit together with the government and make the decision for the country. So this is the reason why there should be a representative from each area, okay, of the country, all the parts of the country. Okay, next is democratic decision making. So how is democracy, democratic form of government and decision making? A democratic decision involves consultation with and consent of all those people who are affected by that decision. Power and non-powerful people should have the same say in taking the decision. This can apply to the government or a family or any other organization. So in a democratic form of government, what this decision involves in consultation with the consent of the people. So the government have to make the decision in the favor of the people, okay, with consulting with the representatives. Okay, whether the powerful or non-powerful, the decision should be same. The decision of the government should be same to all the people. Okay, thus democracy is the principle that can be applied to any sphere of life and can take many forms. So thus democracy is the principle that can be applied to any sphere, okay, of life and can take many forms. So democracy can take many forms in any sphere of life, okay, because whatever the decision made by the leader, okay, is made in consulting with the other minister also. So it's very rare chance that the decision does not work. Okay, in a democracy, every citizen must be able to play an equal role in decision making. So in the democratic country, every citizen have to play or will have to play an equal role in decision making. Okay, for this, an equal right to vote is not sufficient. Every citizen needs to have equal information. So every citizen needs to have equal information what the government is doing. Okay, basic education, equal resources, and lot of commitment are made to the people before the election, but after the election, those commitments are not fulfilled by the government. So this happens in most of the cases in the democratic country. Okay, if we take their ideas seriously, then no country in the world is perfect democracy. So if we follow the feature of the democracy properly, then no country in the world is perfect democratic. Okay, every democracy had to try to realize the ideas of democratic decision making. It cannot be achieved once and for all. It requires a constant effort to save and strengthen democratic form of decision making. So if we look at the features of the democracy properly, then no country in the world is a perfect democratic country. But still, there are some countries who are trying to fulfill all the feature of democracy, okay, and give the people the right, okay, to vote, right to right of freedom of expression in decision making also, okay. So it requires the consent effort of everyone. So there should be the effort of the people, from the people side also, not only from the government, from all the people side also, to make a good democratic country. Okay, so with that we have got to an end of this chapter. So I hope you all are clear with this chapter, what is democracy and why is democracy. Okay, so if you have any problem in understanding the chapter or in understanding any of the subtopic, so you can always text me in my personal number, or we are having virtual class, that time we can discuss whatever you have not understood. So till then, stay home, stay safe, and have a nice day.